Amerik Becker, the New Zealand naturopath. Thank you for coming to my channel. If this is your first time, please check out the other videos. There's a lot of stuff on this channel. So, can omega-3 fish oil cause diarrhea? Well, a lot of things can cause diarrhea. Of course, omega-3 fish oil can cause diarrhea, but generally, if you're smart, and if you're starting omega-3, you'll start with one capsule per day, maybe for 2 or 3 days with the main meal, and then you'll go for the next several days, maybe 2 capsules, and then eventually you'll take 1 capsule 3 times per day. I always insist that on this channel that if you're starting on a supplement, don't just jump into the deep end, okay? Put your toe in the shallow end first to test the water. I think you understand what I mean. Test the water first, then put your foot in it, and if it's okay, proceed with caution. But how many people break their necks every year when they jump into a pool and they can't see the bottom? They end up in a wheelchair. It's really sad, but a little bit of thinking would prevent the wheelchair problem, if you know what I mean. Personally, the only diarrhea I get is from the stuff I read online on YouTube. I look at, you know, some blog sites I've looked at on nutritional medicine. I looked at one the other day. I almost got instant diarrhea, not from what I ate, but from what I read. All chicken is toxic. No one should eat any birds with feathers because they belong to some blah blah kingdom. Get out of here. Go to Mars with Elon Musk. Leave us alone on Earth, for goodness sakes. That's what causes me diarrhea. People who just spout nonsense. But diarrhea can occur with many, many different types of issues here. So it's not just necessarily omega-3. Many people get loose stools from overeating. They eat too late at night, or they have weird combinations of food, you know. They'll have a main meal, then after the main meal, 20 minutes or 10 minutes later, I'll have a huge dessert with a couple of glasses of dessert wine or Dr. Pepper. Or so basically, you're overloading the gut, the capacity for the gut to work efficiently. So often, these are the sort of people that wake up very early in the morning, around 5 or 6, and make a beeline for the bathroom. And they've eaten too much. So too much food is a leading cause of diarrhea. Bad combinations. I'm not in the food combining, but not so good combination would be eating a major meal and then having 3 scoops of ice cream, you know, and maybe 1/2 can of fruit on top of that. That's not a really great combination, you know, the main meal. Also combining weird foods together that some people tend to do. But the portion sizes can often dictate if it's going to be loose or not, in my opinion. So eating less and eating smaller portion size is a big help if you've got loose stools. So start slowly. Now, I've had over the years people come back to me complaining omega-3, they would say the fish oil's rotten or it's off or it's no good. And I'd say, well, why? Well, I took 6 yesterday and I got cramping and bloating and then had diarrhea. And then my question to the patient would be, have you had 6 before? No, it's the first time I've taken 6. I say, well, maybe start on 1 or 2 for a few weeks and then gradually build up, you know? So remember, always go slow in the beginning. There, I won't go on about that anymore. Now, if you're on a drug, you could be on a non-steroidal drug like diclofenac, like ibuprofen, like paracetamol. You could be taking that 2 times a day or 3 times a day. You could be taking a cholesterol-lowering drug, and the cholesterol-lowering drugs like Lipitor are known to really stimulate gut issues in many patients I've seen and cause diarrhea. So if you've got loose stools and you're taking a medication, go to your doctor. Tell your doctor you've got loose stools, and then the doctor will hopefully, if the doctor's smart, withdraw the drug for a little while to see if the bowel improves. Okay, many drugs mess up the liver, and when the liver's messed up, your poop's messed up. Okay, how many times did you go to a bar? How many times did you go to a wine bar, or you were at a friend's place and you drank 3 or 4 glasses of wine and you had a meal and then you went home and the next morning it wasn't looking good in the bathroom? Okay, this is what I'm talking about. These are the issues that people need to look at. Don't point the finger at the omega-3 when you've had 3 glasses of wine or you've had 4 prawn cocktails and maybe a pizza. This is the issue, folks. Think what goes in here, but before you think what goes in there, think here what you're going to put in there, and then usually that can solve a lot of problems. Now, you might find that a sarcastic way of putting it, but I always found it a fun way of putting it, and the patient would laugh. Or I would notice a response in the patient, like a surprise. Oh, can't you do that? And I'd say, well, it's not really appropriate, is it? So a tiny little thing that you pick up from this video could save you a lot of misery, right? It has for a lot of patients. So if you've had your gallbladder removed, it's a given that there is going to be a time when you're going to have diarrhea. You're going to have a bowel problem. You're going to have either constipation or diarrhea. When you take the gallbladder out of the body, you're removing a big reservoir of bile, and bile is required for softening the stool. It's a good way to get rid of junk out of the body. The liver can take over the role, but it's not quite as efficient. So many people who've had a cholecystectomy or gallbladder taken out may experience diarrhea. So in that case, you need to work with digestive enzymes, okay? Especially fat-busting ones with lipases in it, for example. Amylase, lipase, you know, starch and fat-busting enzymes. This is gonna help your gut tremendously. So many people my age, particularly 60 plus, really benefit from digestive enzymes because their stomach's gone flat, has lost the pep. So I'd say 50 plus, loose stools, try digestive enzyme, could make all the difference. Now the second thing I need to tell you about this is try and get used to having more oils and fats in your diet. Slowly, slowly, slowly build up levels of flaxseed oil and, you know, extra virgin olive oil, for example. I have a tablespoon, at least one, if not two tablespoons of olive oil daily, and about a tablespoon of flaxseed oil. I have fish oil, so I try and have all these oils in my diet, and my stool ain't loose at all. As I said, the only time I get that is when, yeah, well, you know. What else can I say? The other handy thing, and often quite essential thing to do with loose stools, is to improve the bowel flora. Okay, so look at digestive enzymes with probiotics combined, because that's an even more powerful combination. To pep up the digestion, improve the breakdown of fats, carbs, you know, starches, for example, proteins, and then also facilitate a better balance of the microbiome further down, reducing the chances of diarrhea. Right? And that's it. I better go before I give you diarrhea. Thanks for tuning in.